Those who have been on the forums longer usually have more experience with features than others. If you are one of those people, or just have a keen eye, you may have seen on my About section that I was a former staff member on Hypixel. Is this true? Yes, it absolutely is. It wouldn't be there if it wasn't. Daily, I get messages from people in-game, on the forums, and Twitter, asking why I haven't gone back to that life. If you've been one of those people, chances are I've told you that it's a long story or that I didn't want to talk about it. But after careful deliberation and planning, I have finally decided that it is time to go into detail about my time on the server as a staff member, as well as the experience of it, and what happened in the immediate aftermath and how it affects today. Before I start this topic, however, I do want to mention that, due to not wanting the video to be turned into a hate video directed towards certain people, I will not be attacking any arguments or showing any opinion on what happened. This video is informative only, and its goal is to inform the community what happened and why it happened. If I say any opinions, they're going to be what I was thinking at the time, not now, due to them being a direct factor into some of the story. I already know this is going to disappoint those who want a good old-fashioned war to happen between me and the team, but that's not going to be the case. All of this was years and years ago, and I have put it all past me since then. If you go after the team for this video, green is your favorite color. If you want a more argumentative and aggressive video, I recommend Ally MCC's video regarding her departure from the staff team. We each share similar, although not identical, staff stories, and her video definitely goes more into it versus my video, which will be informative only. Her videos will be in the description if you want to watch. I am making this video so people have an answer when they ask me this question. My second ever post on the forums was an application to become a helper. It took me 8 applications and a lot of publicity before I had an application accepted. It was made on February 17th, 2014, nearly 8 months after joining the forums, and nearly a year after joining the server. The team at this time was very unnatural. This was when Kevin was the leader of the staff management team, and the staff team consisted of maybe 30 to 40 people. I remember there being an unusual shortage of staff members at that time, and the team was accepting more applications than usual. I, fortunately, happened to be one of those applications. What's most strange, however, is the timeline of how I became staff. My application made it to stage 2 the day of being posted. I then made it to the interview stage 2 days after, had my interview 2 days after that, and then became a helper that same day. This means from posting my application to becoming a helper, it took less than a week. Keep this in mind, as this is super important for what happened later down the road. Once I got the rank, people congratulated me left and right, and it was an amazing feeling. This was something I tried to get for months now, and to finally be able to do it after 8 applications was the best feeling in the world, and I was hoping that dedication would inspire others to not give up on their quest to get helper, and maybe go even further than that. Sadly, however, the story in the long run would not be a happy one overall. All the people that were in the staff team at the time, with a select few being exceptions, were super professional and didn't really like my out there personality at the time. It was a rough time back then. At the time, it was super hard for me to fit in any groups, and I had only just begun starting to talk to people in voice chats and such. It was clear that the majority of the staff team back then really didn't like me or the ways I acted. On top of that, I was never as active as I hoped I would be. Fun fact. Sophomore year in high school means a lot of homework. I had made my application when I did because I had believed applications usually took weeks or even a month to be processed and accepted or denied. Unfortunately, that wasn't the case, and I got accepted nearly immediately, throwing off my activeness on the server with my schoolwork at the time. On top of this, I was dealing with a living in two houses scenario, where one house didn't have a computer that I could play on the server on, extremely hindering my activeness. To date, there are only 2 pieces of evidence, publicly, that even show me as a staff member. One is a picture taken by Kevin during one of his signature cool parties, where you can see my blue name in the tab menu, and the other is a video during Arena Brawl Beta, which some YouTubers took video on, showing me in the lobby as a helper. It's also important to remember that being staff in early 2014 was nothing like being staff now. Back in 2014, the maximum player count was like 15,000 or something, maybe even less. The system was very different, so don't ask me what being staff is like, as what it was like then is nothing like it is now, and I won't have any good answers for you. After about a month of this going back and forth scenario, I was removed from the staff team by Kevin. I was never given any official message on the matter until Lady Clockwork, a moderator at the time, had to message me and tell me I was removed. Sometime later, Kevin finally sent me a message regarding it, whose Skype message officially stated the reasons I was removed were inactivity and being weird and not fitting in. Those were his words. I accepted this because at the time, I was a stupid teenager who didn't understand the scope of what he meant. I waited the month requirement before applying again, explaining that I had figured out my computer scenario, my workload had disappeared, and I was going to take speech classes to help me blend in better with the staff team. Unfortunately, Fraley's AD came back to me with a haunting message that still stings to read to this day. This was your 9th application, and I don't want to be rude, but you will not be getting the chance to become helper again. I know that this might be heartbreaking, but you can keep up what you're doing. We do appreciate that you are not rude, respectful of other applicants slash players slash staff, but for becoming staff again, it's just not going to work out. At the time, I was devastated. Not knowing the whole story at the time, I completely believed 100% it was my fault and that I messed up my loan shot. I spent the next 2 years not really thinking about it too much, doing my best to build my image in the community. Just last year, Kevin had been fired, and as much as I wanted to, I decided to try to not pursue removing this blacklist as it happened, as I thought it would have been a bad time. In 2016 though, I was in an extremely rough place. My moods were all over the place, and culminated in me leaving Hypixel for a few months and becoming a Hive member instead. It started when word got spread about why Kevin was fired. I don't know why, but something about that put a fire under me. I was in a heated situation with myself and suddenly realized that this blacklist from years ago might have been a shady one, and with a new staff management team, I could potentially get it removed. I started by quietly asking Robbity Bobbity, the current leader of app team and a staff manager, to look into it and figure out the official reasons I was blacklisted, as being weird and not fitting in wasn't a viable answer for me anymore. Robbity did not directly answer the question, so I asked again, more strictly this time, and she didn't answer it again, instead trying to not bring up reasons whatsoever and just saying that my blacklist would remain. Had Robbity decided to tell me upfront specific reasons, it was clear no conflict would have ever happened. However, after feeling ignored and spat on, I decided to take probably the biggest risk I ever took in the community, one that I'm still happy with even to this day. I had made my own blogging site a bit earlier, and I decided to use it to write an extremely long and demanding blog, grilling the application team, especially Robbity. I criticized the lack of care, the suspicious hiding of reasoning behind the blacklist, the transparency, among other things. I shared the blog everywhere in the sole attempt of forcing Robbity to respond like she should have at the very beginning.
It's intermission time.
Hey everyone, welcome to intermission. Feel free to relax, grab some more popcorn, get some more drinks, use the bathroom, I don't care. I thought this would be the perfect time to just remind everyone that I no longer have conflict with anyone and that this has all been put past me. This video is 100% informative and its goal is to inform what happened, why it happened, and what my thoughts were at the time that led me to do the things I did and say the things I said. Do not go attack anyone. That is an order from your favorite blue guy. Okay, back to the show. The blog post got a lot of attention, and tons of people widely praised the blog for being hard-hitting and straight to the point. It was only after the community spammed this blog post at Robbity that she finally sat down and wrote out a detailed and very high-effort response explaining the blacklist. Of course, I was more relieved than anything, because this was all I wanted in the first place. After Robbity said her words and I said mine in response, me and Robbity then debated some more about some of the accuracy regarding the response, as well as questioning some of the motivation. Understandably, Robbity got annoyed after a little bit and decided to cut the conversation shortly after. I still still had huge doubts about the legitimacy and widely believed that she was purely thinking about Kevin's reasoning and not deciding on her own. For a very, 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 very short time, I thought about accusing her of being a post-supporter of Kevin, but I immediately knew that would be a terrible, terrible idea and likely wasn't even true to begin with. Unfortunately, the blog post can no longer be found as the blog was a Weebly blog and the site has expired since then. Even the Internet Wayback Machine has nothing archived on it. This rise in conflict, climax, and falling out of this scenario led to some very eccentric behavior for me. Dropped by what happened from back then, on top of responsibilities of running the Hypixel show, which was still doing pretty well, and senioritis from school, I announced in a rushed haze that I would be leaving the Hypixel community in a twit longer. I talked about the distress I was feeling from being in this community run by a group of people who I thought wanted nothing to do with me, and that the Hive community was a much more joyous place to be at. I forget how long I was part of the Hive, but it wasn't very long, maybe a few months at most, as I was back shortly after. This was the last big fuss regarding what happened, at least from my end. At that point, I had finally come to terms with the fact that I just wasn't gonna win. I was a single teenager, and they were a team of adults, and even if I was right and could prove it, I still wouldn't have won. About a year later, I had my last ever interaction with an admin regarding this. I had, out of nowhere, decided to message Hypixel support, asking them if there was anything I could do about this. Tomcat Eve responded to my support ticket and, to my pleasant surprise, declared that no such list existed from back then, stating that I wasn't blacklisted from anything, only to pull the rug out from under me like 20 minutes later. This increased my suspicion by 200% regarding the true motivation of the application team, but I decided it wasn't worth my time, cause, like I said before, I never had a chance of coming close to winning. So that brings us to today. Am I still upset about how it all went down? Yeah, definitely. I'm sure anyone who was in my position would be too. I can think of many times where I knew I should have said something else. Maybe I should have worded that a little bit differently. Am I happy where I am now? You bet I am. I'm super proud of what I've been able to build on the site and where I've made it since I first made my account. I'm not able to predict what might have happened had I actually become a full-on staff member beyond Helper. I may not have become the 7th most followed person on the entire site out of 2.5 million plus members. I may not have had the time to be active on the forums and become the top poster for many years. I may not have gotten the opportunity to run the Hypixel show or had a real newspaper article be written about me. So many things that might not have happened had this story gone in a different direction. When I look at it in that sense, I'm happy that I never became anything more than a helper that lasted for a month. And if I were to be offered the position today, I likely wouldn't accept it. On that note, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everyone who's given me the chance to be myself, and the staff members from back then that didn't treat me like trash. You know who you guys are. I'd also like to give a quick thanks to everyone who's been subscribing recently. My numbers have gone up through the roof, and I could not be happier regarding it. Some fun content is coming soon, and I can't wait for you guys to check it out. I know the feeling of this video is drastically different from my usual talk about videos, but this topic is one that reminds me of a lot of sour memories, and I wanted to make it a calm experience to talk and share about. No anger should come from this video whatsoever, which is what the goal of it was, alongside informing people about my experience so that I have a video to link whenever someone asks now. That's all for now. I'll see you guys around.